As the saying goes, the third time is the charm. And that was very much true for SpaceX. Two spectacular flights which had two different kind of spectacular crash landings. The third time was almost the charm. The Starship SN10 is a huge next-generation spacecraft that Elon Musk, the founder and chief executive officer of SpaceX, dreams to send to Mars. As SpaceX sent this Starship prototype flying high above the Texas coast on Wednesday, it successfully completed the ascension into the sky and this time returned to the ground and landed in one piece. But minutes later, it exploded due to a possible methane leak. But regardless of this explosion, it was a great success for the private space company. With this success, we are one step closer to Mars. Elon Musk's company is churning out Starship test vehicles in Boca Chica, Texas, at the company's test facility, and very recently they began testing the launch and landing capabilities in daring flights. The big stainless steel SN10 launched from Boca Chica at 6:15 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, rose to 6.2 miles into the sky, and then came back to Earth for a smooth touchdown 6 minutes and 20 seconds after liftoff. Today in this video, we take a look at the major changes that happened in Starship SN10 with respect to SN8 and SN9, and why it exploded minutes after the landing. So make sure to watch the video until the end to know the significance of Starship SN10 for us and our future of becoming interplanetary species. How the SN10 Starship successfully landed then exploded. Do you know why Starship is so important? Imagine a rocket that could launch and land 1,000 times a year. Sounds unbelievable? Well, that's what SpaceX is working on, the Starship. Its lifting capacity of 100,000 kilograms is more than any rocket currently in operation. And the whole system is designed to be reusable for frequent trips to space. It will launch atop a large booster called Super Heavy. Super Heavy will be the backbone of getting Starship and its crew on a journey to another world. The ultimate goal of Starship is to launch up to 100 people at a time per flight. Before SN10, its predecessor SN8 failed to stick to the landing, but it gave valuable data to the company to make modifications for the future, which the company did. Before discussing what happened to Starship SN10, we will first discuss the major design changes that SpaceX implemented in the Starship. And this time, you might know how SpaceX works. They basically keep testing these prototypes, and during each and every test, they gather a huge amount of valuable data. Then they can analyze the data and make necessary hardware and software changes in the future prototypes. So naturally, SN10 is kind of an evolved version of SN8 and SN9. SN8 was expected to have 33% probability of completing all the mission objectives, but SN8 did far better than that. SN9 also suffered a major landing failure. But what's important here is that both of these landing failures were unique, and failure is the most expected outcome in these test flights. Though SN8 and SN9 didn't land, they did show us two different scenarios of what might go wrong while landing in the future. These failures contribute a lot to the program's success. For example, because of the failure of Starship SN8, SpaceX realized the problem of maintaining adequate pressure in the header tanks, and so they made some design changes and added a helium header tank in SN9. But this time, SN9 had a completely different cause of landing failure. They realized that relighting two Raptor engines can also lead to failure, as Raptors are not fully matured yet and are still in the development phase. SpaceX realized that they can't eliminate this by reigniting all three Raptor engines during the Starship flip maneuver. So SpaceX performed a mid-air static fire, giving the rocket flight computer a few seconds to analyze the performance of the Raptor engines and downslip to two of the healthiest Raptors. Starship SN10 was the first high-altitude prototype to perform a three Raptor engine flip burn. The second major change in Starship SN10 was the installation of a flight termination system, FTS. It was installed as a safety measure in the event that Starship loses control and passes a certain point outside its approved trajectory. The FTS would explode, triggering a vehicle breakup. However, looking at the historical data, the Starship prototypes have done a pretty good job at sticking to their planned trajectory, so there is a very low probability that a flight termination system would be triggered. but it's better to be safe than sorry. As the sun set over the test site in Boca Chica, Texas on March 3, 2021, the latest prototype SN10 lifted off, its stainless steel exterior soaring high up in the sky, ascending over an altitude of over 6 miles. It was the second launch attempt of the day. 3 hours earlier, the liftoff of SN10 was aborted with just fractions of seconds left in the countdown. The engines were ignited and ready to lift off, but then were shut off when the computer on board detected too much thrust from one of the engines. Elon Musk updated us about the development on Twitter and also stated that SpaceX would be tweaking the flight software thrust limit and also recycle the propellant for another shot at the launch. The engineers then realized the problem was not significant, adjusted the software, and tried again. Earlier, the Starship was rolled out to the launch pad on January 28th. Starship SN10 lifted off just 5 weeks later, the fastest factory-to-launch pad yet. The speed of the turnaround was made possible thanks to a comparatively very smooth launch campaign, passing the cryogenic proof and static fire tests in just a few attempts. SN10 attempted the launch for the second time. The three Raptor engines ignited again, and this time they stayed on. The rocket then rose into the Texas sky for the target in altitude. The ascent of Starship SN10 was very similar to its predecessors SN8 and SN9, flying under the power of three Raptor engines. At around T plus 15 seconds of the ascent, the Starship switched back to the two Raptor engines for the remaining phase of ascent. At around 8 kilometers of altitude, the Starship shifted its control to a single Raptor engine as it neared the apogee of 10 kilometers. And quite unsurprisingly, once at its highest point, the prototype shut down the last remaining Raptor engine and successfully completed the belly flop maneuver, switching the controls to the aerodynamic surfaces of the rocket. Except for the last few seconds, the Starship SN10 did nothing new in its flight. Just like its predecessors, the prototype had a stable ascent and did a successful belly flop maneuver and also had a controlled descent under its aerodynamic surfaces. The only thing that was different in this test flight was the landing approach. As discussed earlier, instead of relighting two engines for the flip maneuver descent, the Starship was going to relight all three Raptor engines. This was going to be followed by switching back to two of the healthiest Raptors before ultimately going down to a single Raptor to touchdown, and to everyone's delight, SN10 performed the landing burn just as planned. SN10 relighted all the three Raptor engines, switched to two Raptor engines, and ultimately went down to a single Raptor engine before a successful touchdown. And there we have it, SN10, the first full-scale Starship prototype to successfully complete the high-altitude flight test. But if you were someone who was looking at this for the first time, you can tell that something's wrong here, and there are some questions that arise. First of all, where are the landing legs? And why is Starship looking like the Leaning Tower of Boca Chica? And then why is there a fire next to the prototype? All the suspicious ingredients collectively form the recipe of what is called, you guessed it right, a rapid, unscheduled disassembly, just a few minutes after SpaceX's live stream ended. Starship SN10 then decided to follow the path of its predecessors and just exploded. So what went wrong with the Starship? When we take a closer look at the final few seconds of the landing phase of SN10, it becomes pretty evident that the landing was not as smooth as you can clearly see. And SN10 bounced after touchdown, and as far as we now know, bouncing is something that rockets don't like to do. This bounce clearly indicated that SN10 did not have a soft landing. The hard landing also explains why we cannot see the landing legs, because the landing legs were not there. They could just not absorb the force of the hard landing, but this still does not explain the explosion. The explosion happened after several minutes, and not immediately. One of the possible reasons could be the flight termination system. As SN10 was leaning towards one side, the flight termination system could have triggered the explosion. But when you take a closer look at the explosion, it's clear that the point of explosion was at the bottom of the rocket, and the flight termination system is not there. So this possibility is not in the cards, so there remains only one possible explanation according to us. As you can see, there was a propellant leak just before the explosion, so we can say that the bounce may have caused some sort of structural damage to SN10, leading to a propellant leak which ultimately caught fire, resulting in the explosion of SN10. But nonetheless, Starship has demonstrated that the new landing approach works, and now SpaceX just needs to find a solution for the landing legs. Even though it was not a soft landing, it's still the first Starship prototype to successfully complete the complex high-altitude flight test. SpaceX is developing Starship to get people and payloads to the Moon, Mars, and other distant destinations, and to fly any other missions the company requires. The final Starship will be brawny enough to get itself off the Moon and Mars, but it will need Super Heavy's help to get off our much more massive Earth. After launching Starship to Earth orbit, the huge booster will come back down to Earth for a vertical landing, as Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy first stages already do. Next up, we have Starship SN11, almost ready, and we'll be seeing another Starship flight very soon, and we really hope it will have a complete success. So what do you think about the Starship SN10 flight test? How much closer are we to going to Mars? Do you think it was a success, and why? And how will it affect our future in spaceflight? Do let us know your thoughts and ideas in the comment section below. Also, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel. And if you like the video, share it with your friends. It encourages us to keep making videos like this for you. Thanks.